All right, the Slack pack for Coda is one of the easiest ways to kind of automate your work, send messages, and extend and make your Coda docs feel that much richer. I'm going to show you everything you need to know about the Slack pack today. So let's go. All right, so first thing, we just need to install the pack. There's a lot of ways that you can install packs. We can slash it in if we want, S-L-A-C-K. You'll see this, more packs by Slack, but the normal way to grab packs is with your insert packs or integrations. Sometimes it will say integrations, and we are going to add the Slack one. You don't want the templates, you want the actual pack itself. Once you click on this, it'll say add to doc. You're gonna add it to your doc. This is adding it not to every Coda doc you have, but just to this one individual doc. All right, you can see a lot of different things we have with this pack. You can see that we've got users, channels. We have the ability to create channels, post messages, join channels, leave, invite, some cards, and permalinks and other information. The most things you're gonna use really are this post a message. You're gonna use Coda all the time with buttons to post messages automatically or by user input to Slack. So we're gonna look and see how to do that now. All right, so first when we send our post message button, let's drag it in. If we drag it in, you'll see here that it's got a couple different things going on. You've got mode, private, and shared. If it's private, you can have one button and every single person who pushes it will need to log in with their own account. This is actually really genius for a lot of different use cases where you want a single button and you want the user to press it. You want the message to show up as from them. So you need to make that decision, like, do you want this to be a private one where whoever presses it, it sends from their account, or shared where it sends from some sort of shared account. But let's go ahead and put it to share. Once you log in here, you're gonna see I can select Slack accounts. These are not automatically here for you unless you've previously connected them somewhere inside of Coda. So you'll probably see, if you've never used this before, the add new account button. What you're gonna do then is you're gonna choose one. Some best practice ideas, you'll see here that I have one for myself, Scott Weir, but I also have one called SimplaBot. Sometimes organizations choose to make a general, non-person specific Slack account to use with the Slack pack for Coda. It just allows you to have like notifications at coda.io, right? Or just some sort of general account. So when these messages show up in Slack, people know that they're not coming from an actual person, but they're coming from an automation in the setting. So let's set up ours as SimpleBot. We'll use our general Slack thing. And we'll see here, we have the account, already the account that we connected with, and content. Our content allows us to write all sorts of different things. Hey there. And lastly, your channel or your email, you're just gonna type this in directly. You're gonna put in @general, for example. Type that in directly and you'll be good. You'll also notice here that if it is a private channel, you'll need to find the actual channel ID. Okay, there's a couple more things you can add, like thread timestamp, apply broadcast, ignore failures and other things, but you won't normally need this. You'll just need these. So normally though, you're not gonna use it inside of a thing by itself. We're gonna learn how to personalize message here. So we learned how to install the pack, best practices for account access. We're gonna move and learn how to send personalized messages, but before, one more thing to say about account access. If you go to your settings for the pack itself, you'll see here, you can see shared accounts, and you can see private accounts. A lot of people have bugs, or they're like, it's not working, but because they don't recognize that their shared accounts aren't set correctly, this shared account can take actions and view data. That's usually what you want to be able to do. So now let's go look how to send messages in a practical use case as well. Let's go over to Slack. We're gonna come here and we are going to, first just let's make a task table. Let's say you have a task tracker for projects. So let's get a task table in here. All right, so here we are. We've got our tasks at a tech company. You've got your task, your status, you've got your due date, and you've got the person responsible. Obviously, these are probably going to be a little bit different, right? This will probably be a select list, and this responsible will probably be a people column. Okay, well, let's put that in here. Let's put Scott. Let's put more results. Let's put Aaron. And let's put more results. Let's put Steven. And let's put scat. All right. So now we got a task, but maybe we want to send a message to someone when this task is due. So if we come here, we are going to make a new column. That column will be send notification of due. We can come here and we'll make this column a button column. So you're going to come to the column types and type in button. Once you do that, you'll make it a new button. And on click, you are going to send message or notify user. You're going to send it as a Slack message. Notice it has the same options for private or mode. And now in our content, notice there's this fancy A here. So I'm going to show you how to personalize these messages. It's very simple. You can just start typing, hey there. And then we can type line breaks and all sorts of other fun stuff. But we could say the task at task is due today. Right, so that's gonna actually pull the task from the row itself. We can actually see this in a compose column. If you wanna check what this is gonna look like beforehand, you can write it like this. Hey there, and then you could say at task is due today. So you'll notice here that it's grabbing that develop new website, right? If I go down, fix bug in mobile app, that's gonna be different per row. You can also run some custom formulas in here as well, right? Like if for some reason I didn't want the task, but I wanted it all uppercase, you could say, you could press the equal button on your keyboard, boop, and that'll bring up a formula. And now I can say task.upper, right? So now you'll see that I have a special formula inside here, creating kind of a perfect format for my team. I can also do that there. Instead of saying there, we could say equal to responsible.name, right? So now I've got, hey, Scott Weir, develop new website is due today. So if I do that, let's go ahead and let's just copy that, right? You can see that. That's what it looks like. Yep, looks good. Let's delete that. Let's then put that into here and boom, there we go. Channel or email, right? Same thing again, if you're gonna send that to a general channel, or maybe you could send it to an email as well. If you wanted to, you could press the equal button here and you could say responsible.email, right? And then that's gonna send to that individual. So there we go. If you're gonna have that, you can also press these via automations or really extend this in any other way that you want to. Next though, I'm gonna show you Slack has some very specific tips and tricks around formatting. If you want to at mention someone, make something bold, it's got some special tricks that are specific to Slack. I'm gonna show you how to use those tips and tricks next. All right, so let's say you're wanting to send messages in Slack to individuals or channels and you want to at mention someone, you want to hyperlink something, or you want to make something bold. I will show you all three of those right now. What we're gonna do, Slack has some very specific conventions about how you're gonna actually do this. So let's say that we wanted to make develop new website bold, for example. In order to do that, you can go to this website, and I'll have this down in the comments below, but you can see this and this will show you all the different ways that you can do it. It's very long and lengthy. I'm gonna show you kind of the most common ones real fast, but here you'll see that it's saying, hey, you know what? If you wanna make this bold, surround it with two asterisks. So let's go back and let's go back to our Slack pack and let's go to here. And just to show it, I'm gonna show this in the compose column itself. So I'm gonna make a new column one more time and it's gonna be compose. We are going to push this here. And we just simply put these around there. Almost, there we go. All right, there should be no spaces in between there. It should simply just be like that. So this is going to be the message. All right, and then let's do this. Let's push in here. I'm just gonna actually reference at message, okay. And now what we are going to do, I'm gonna send this and I'll show you an example. You'll see exactly how it showed up in Slack in just a moment. Let's send this actually instead to the, actually that should work. Let's do it. Here we go. Send message. Hey Scott, we're developing a new website is due today. One Slack message sent. All right, so here you go. Here you can see the Slack message right here. Totally worked, made it bold. So you can play with these different pieces to make them work. But let's look at a hyperlink next. Hyperlinks are a bit more interesting. They're not like anything you've probably ever seen. Let's say that you had a link column, right? And maybe it was a link to a Jira ticket or some other thing where it had it, right? www. simpledocs.com. We're just gonna put that website in for now. And let's change our message to actually hyperlink that. The task link can be found at, all right, so Slack, what it wants you to do is put it inside of these double carrots. So we're gonna put those double carrots real fast. And then we are going to put our bar in the middle, and there's gonna be two things on each side of that bar. First, we're gonna put the at link. Oops, that's not working. Let's try this link. And then on the other side of the bar, you're gonna put what you want the link to display as. So, right, task link, okay? There we go. You'll now see that how this shows up is a little bit interesting, right? Develop new website, stars. This going on here looks a little weird, but let's press our message and see how it actually shows up. Okay, send message. All right, and here's the Slack message that just sent. So that's how that's gonna show up. You can kind of use that to format your Slack messages as much as you want. So make sure to check out the comments below and find that link. The last thing we're gonna look at is how to at mention someone. All right, so let's go ahead and learn how to at mention someone inside of our Slack messages. Maybe you're sending this to a general channel. Maybe it's a project. So you want the whole project to have visibility on what's going on, but you want to at mention someone specifically. What we're going to do is first, let's just change this to a channel, right? So let's delete that. I'm going to put this into a, I don't want it to be a formula. It already is a formula. That's okay. We could just put it in quotes and I'll say general random. That is the name of one of the channels within my Slack account. What we're going to do now is we want to at tag this responsible person. Slack requires that we use their Slack ID. How the heck do we find their Slack ID? Let's build a new page. It's rather quite easy. We're going to go ahead and insert. Let's go back to packs for you and go back to your installed packs of Slack, and you're going to bring in your list of users. So we're going to bring in that list of users, and you can hide deleted users, and let's sync that right now. It takes a couple seconds to sync, especially depending on how many users you have and how large your organization is. But here we go. We got our different users, and you'll see here there is no Slack ID. Don't worry. It's just hiding. Hover over this little dot, and you're going to see the team ID, and there should be a... Wow, look at that big avatar. Oh, that's because he's a theme. Let's go here. There we go. ID. Unhide. So now I've got this ID, and this is how we're going to reference these. You do not have to do this manually. We can automate this. Let's call this Slack users. All right, let's go back in the Slack pack, and now I'm going to find the Slack user ID based off the responsible individual. So inside of the responsible individual, there is something really fun. Names, photos, and emails. Pull out the emails of the individuals, right? Now let's use that and reference our users table to find the Slack ID. Let's turn this into a formula using the equal button. Press on the entire column, so it's all blue. Press equals on your keyboard, and you're gonna pull up a formula. Now I'm gonna say users. That's my Slack users table. Dot filter, so go and look inside the table itself and find only rows where the email is equal to this row. Dot emails of responsible. Let's add a first because we only want one person, and then we're gonna add an ID. All right. So that, no, we don't want a row ID. We want the ID. There we go. All right. So now you'll see that this is grabbing out programmatically the Slack user ID. And you'll notice that this changes automatically depending on who I put as the person responsible. Okay, so let's go here. Emails of responsible. Notice that it has QKJA. The moment I change this to Aaron, you'll notice that it changes back to her Slack ID. Great, we've programmatically accessed Slack IDs using the Slack user tables. The last thing we need to do is input this individual to at tag him. So let's learn how to do that. Let's go into our compose. I keep opening this with the equal button really quickly. And instead of saying responsible.name, we want to at tag them. Slack is going to have us do it in this format. We're once again going to do our double carrots. Inside of our double carrots, we're going to do the at symbol, an actual at symbol. And then next to that, we're going to put their Slack ID. So we're going to grab the Slack user ID. Great. Let's not bug my teammate Aaron. Let's bug myself. You'll send this message. It looks a little weird here on the Coda side, right? But let's look how it shows up inside of Slack. So here we go. We're gonna send that message, and the Slack message is sent. All right, let me know if you got any questions about the Slack pack. at all whatsoever, or other packs that you'd like me to cover in the comments below. See you guys.